Hi ladies, today we are doing a coppery bronzed Rodeo Queen makeup look. This is one of my personal favourites. To start off with, I go in with MAC Prep and Prime to prevent any oiliness or shininess during the day and to ensure a really smooth and flawless makeup application. I've got a few blemishes on my face today, like most of us girls get, so I'm going through with this LA Girl Pro Conceal in a green shade. Green counteracts redness, so if you've got a big nasty pimple, it's really great to cover it up. Now this is one of the RCMA foundation palettes. These palettes are absolutely amazing and come in a broad array of colours. To get the foundation out of the palette, I just use a spatula and mix it up on my palette to warm the foundation so it's more spreadable. I use a brush when applying the RCMA foundations because they're very, very pigmented and they're quite creamy in consistency. But these foundations are really wonderful. They can come in individual foundations as well. If you just hop on Google, there are quite a few Australian distributors for these professional quality foundations. You can also use all the different shades to contour, highlight or conceal because they are so pigmented. Next, I go in with a tiny bit of RCMA no color powder just to set my foundation. Everybody that's in the place. This is the same brand as that green concealer I used on my little red spots. This is the LA Girl Pro Conceal. When I am fake tan, I love highlighting. It's really different for me because usually when I'm fair skin toned, highlighting isn't as noticeable for me. So that's one of the reasons that I fake tan, because I can use a darker foundation and I can be more intricate with my highlighting and my contouring. So I just apply the concealer under my eyes and anywhere I want to brighten or lift with that lighter color. For a highlighting concealer, you just want to go a few shades lighter than your foundation color. When you're fair, you almost need a white concealer for there to be any kind of difference from your skin to your highlighting shade. So I'm just going to blend that out with a beauty blender. Surprise! Completed makeup look! No, I'm just kidding. My camera stopped filming for some reason when I was contouring and I had to take my contour off and go back and recontour and refilm. So what I'm just doing here is showing you the line from the outer corner of your eye. You don't want to go past that line. If you contour too close down to your outer corner of your lip, your cheeks will look very gaunt and skeleton-like. So I just contour in the hollows of my cheeks, add dimension to my forehead, my chin, and my nose. Start off with a little bit of product on your brush and build it up. Otherwise, if you're new to contouring and using tools like a brush and powder, you're gonna end up with a big line across your face. We have this Milani Baked Blush called Bellissimo Bronze. It's a really pretty blush color to go with tan skin and a really bronzy, coppery makeup look. It has a little bit of shimmer to it, so it highlights as well. I put blush on the apples of my cheeks, sweep it over my cheekbones and up into my temple. It's really important as a rodeo queen to add that blush to the apples of your cheeks so you look really pretty and flushed. In my personal time, Usually I'll just put blush on my cheekbones and not the apples of my cheeks. So after I've done all my contouring, blushing, I will go through with a little bit of powder on a fluffy brush and go through and blend my face out. This is a liquid highlighter from Benefit. It's called High Beam and it does just that. It makes your cheekbones and your brow bones beam. The packaging is kind of like a nail polish bottle and it's a little bit different applying a liquid highlighter with the blush, but you just blend it out with the beauty blender. I'm now going to go through and do my regular eyebrow routine. So I use the lighter Benefit shade on the first half of my eyebrow and then the darker MAC shade on the tail of my eyebrow. And now for the fun part, putting the actual eye look together. I start off by using a light brown kind of color just on my lid. So not in the crease, but just on my eyelid. And next I sweep this orange color into my crease and the first half of my eyelid from the center outwards, if that makes sense. This color blends out really nicely. It does look very bright and orange when first applied, but it blends out to a coppery kind of color. I was really excited to use it because I haven't used this shade on my palette yet. So I bring that orange shade under my eye as well, just to the center line of my eye. And after each eyeshadow that I apply, I get a big fluffy brush and smoke it out. The next shadow I use is this chocolatey brown color from the Zoeva palette. I'm just using that to darken up the crease and the overall smokiness of the eye look. I also take that under my eye as well. This liquid metallic shadow just goes all over my eyelid and under my eye from the outside corner of my eye to the inside corner of my eye. So there is copper and glitter everywhere. After applying this on my bottom lid, I will get the best tools that you have, which are your fingers, and I just pat the top of my eyelid and smudge it out in the crease so it's not just a straight line where my eyelid is, so it looks a little bit smokier and it blends into that orangey coppery color. Next, I'll go through with just a black eyeliner pencil, a smudgy kind of pencil, and line my bottom waterline and my top waterline or my lash line. This can be a bit uncomfortable to do. It's not my favorite part of my makeup routine, but it makes such a difference with dramatic makeup looks and highlighting your features so your features really stand out in photographs or when you're in the rodeo arena. The hunger satisfied. For fake eyelashes, you really need to make sure you're using good quality tools. To start off with, you need to pull the eyelash off the packaging using a pair of tweezers and measure it up to your eyelid. You will always have to trim the eyelashes down. Trim from the outside, not the inside of the lash. After you've applied a thin layer of glue to the lashes, you need to let them dry a little bit and let the glue get tacky. So you wait about 30 seconds for that. Now I've jumped to the other eye here and I'm going to stick this lash on. So I hold it up to my eyelid and I rest it on my normal lashes so it just sits there. And then I can use my fingers and tweezers to line it up to where I want it to be. You use the end of your tweezers to anchor the lash line to your eyelid. Generally, you start with the center and you work your way out, just tapping really gently. Like I said, make sure you invest in a really good quality lash glue and eyelashes. If you don't do this, it gets really, really frustrating. Your eyelashes will lift, they won't stick down properly, and you're gonna end up late to your event and or just not wearing eyelashes altogether. So cut out the middleman and just get good quality lash glue and eyelashes because it makes such a difference. They're so glamorous. I will then really thoroughly coat my bottom lashes and my top lashes with mascara to stick the fake lashes to my natural lashes. To go in with Old Faithful Kat Von D Everlasting Liquid Lipsticks. I have a dark nude color, it's almost like a brown, and then I go over it with a lighter nude color to lighten it up because this lipstick on its own is probably a little bit too dark for what I would use for rodeo cleaning. I do use this color in my personal time without lightening it, but it is just that touch dark for your classic rodeo queen look. As I said in my previous makeup tutorial, the Everlasting Liquid Lipsticks are so long lasting. You touch your lips, there's no press back, and the color is very pigmented and lasts all day long. But you do need to touch up a few times during the day. I mean, they're not magic. So when I apply my lipstick, I overdraw my top lip just a little bit because my top lip is quite thin. I don't overdraw my bottom lip and I don't go crazy with overdrawing my top lip, otherwise it would be quite noticeable. You and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see, a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. Once I've done my makeup, I use a setting spray. This lets my makeup hold all day long. That's the end of the tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed it. This is one of my go-to looks as the Rodeo Queen of Australia and also in my personal time. I just love coppery bronzy colors. If you guys have any videos that you would like me to do, it doesn't just have to be about makeup or hair, it could be anything to do with rodeo queening. Please let me know down in the comment section and make sure you hit that subscribe button. Bye for now! We're beautiful.